Good morning. Good afternoon. Bonjour. Comment allez-vous? Bonsoir. This is MUSAU MattmeachamJR signing in on planet Earth. I always make a decision. I think I'm going to have to start making decisions like this. I always decide that I'm not going to do any broadcasting. But I don't know. I always end up defying what I contemplated. In fact, what I wanted to do is just to go into, become like invisible and just exist. I mean, not exist, but not exist. In other words, I just wanted to become invisible. There was an author by the name of Ralph Ellison. If anybody in literature, well, in American literature, especially African-American literature, they know the writer, Ralph Ellison. I mean, Ralph Ellison. You know, that may not even be his name. But there was a black, I am in bad shape. But there was a African-American writer who wrote a book called The Invisible Man. This book was written many, many years ago. Now, I read that book when I was in high school, so we're talking about, close to 60 years ago. So I guess that book was probably written almost 100 years ago, but it was written by an African-American artist, an African-American writer by the name of Ralph Ellison, and it was called The Invisible Man. And the thing is, it was quite provocative, because basically what this intellectual African-American writer did, he wrote a book to show how African-Americans were invisible in the sociological setting of American society. It was very well written. There are two Black American writers who I really enjoyed reading when I was a young man. And I think that book by Ellison, Ralph Ellison, called Invisible Man, and many books by James Baldwin, another African American artist. The thing is, it's quite interesting. I don't know what was the gender preference for Ralph Ellison, but I know I enjoyed his book. It's called Invisible. I highly recommend that book if you can ever run across a book called The Invisible Man by Ralph Ellison. But James Baldwin was a homosexual. And you know, I have issues with sodomites, but I have to say this, that man, James Baldwin, a Black American writer, his books were fantastic. One was The Fire Next Time. Oh, I can't remember all the titles, but if you have ever heard of James Baldwin, I'll suggest that you pick up some of his books and read his books. I found them quite interesting. So, in my youth, I always just wanted to be a writer. That was my life ambition. My life ambition was to be a writer. But when I began to become mature, I found out you can't feed yourself by being a writer. So I ventured upon many occupations. One of my other occupations was a taxi driver. I drove taxi in Los Angeles. Hollywood, West Hollywood, Boston, Boston, Las Vegas. I guess in my working days, I was more or less a driver. I went to major cities. I enjoy driving. So when I discovered that you really can't be a writer and feed yourself, I chose to drive taxi. And I learned a lot from driving taxi cab in these major cities. Now, I grew up in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. At the time that I was living in Alabama, Tuscaloosa was a small town in Alabama. And so I wasn't exposed to most of the thing. I heard about the guys in New York City and Detroit, Los Angeles, these guys were cool dudes, but I remember when I went to study in Massachusetts, or I went to Boston, and I would start talking to people, and they hear my southern accent, and everybody, no matter who I would talk to, whether they were white or black, they would always make me feel really, really bad. They say, where are you from? We guys from the South talk different from those guys in New York and Detroit. Those guys in New York and Detroit, those guys were proper. And we were country. If you're from Alabama, which was where I was from, we were considered country. And I know my first year at the university, I must confess, that I had something like a complex, every time I would open my mouth, they would know immediately that I was from down south. We call it down south. And people, your classmates, they would poke fun at you for having your southern accent. But I'm just reminiscing. And the thing is, I'm just reminiscing where I began and where I'm at now. And the thing is, where I'm at now is where it's because of where I began. So I'm whether when you see me doing a broadcast, you probably think that I'm just a bad guy or something like that. But I'm really a nice guy. And the thing is, I love people. I love humanity. So the things most of the things I do, especially when I'm doing a YouTube set, I was trained in drama, and so I do a lot of things. Which you say, "Wow, what is this guy talking about? What is he doing?" Well, I enjoy acting, so you'll probably see me doing a lot of acting if you tune in on my network on my. YouTube station. But the thing is, even though I may seem bodacious, I'm a very shy person. I'm very shy. It's just I love the human being, and I like to interact. If a human being would like to interact with me, I would just enjoy interacting with them. I love animals too. So, I think I'm a pretty good person. And the thing is, maybe if you get to know me, and the best way to get to know me is to read my books. Yes. The best way, if you find me intriguing or interesting, the best way I think that you really could understand this guy here, is to read my books. Yes, I'm trying to get you to buy my books. Yes. But I think my book, I really believe that my books are really good. And I think if you just start reading some of the things that I deal with, you name it, I deal with it. I deal with science fiction. I deal with the racial issues. I deal with the international issues. I deal with biology. I deal with, yes, I deal even with chemistry. Please, all you have to do is just go and just gaze through some of the material that's right over this. You can go right to Amazon and you have a chance to look in the book and see what kind of things that I write about. I write about everything. And the thing is, I must confess, this is a personal advertisement trying to encourage my viewing audience to go and examine my books. And the thing is, you may say this or you may say that, but if you examine my books, you say, wait, hey, that's what he was talking about. I talk about a lot of things. So this is just an advertisement. And that advertisement is basically saying, buy books by Musau MattmeachamJR Jr. Now, I write under several names. If you can buy my books under these names. One is Musau MattmeachamJR, which most of my books are written under that name. But then I have other books. If you see, if you go to the internet and you say books by Musau, MM, those are my books. Okay. Now you can also go to the internet, books by Musau MattmeachamJR Muhammad. That's the whole name. So I write basically under four different names. So if one is Musau MM, one is Musau MattmeachamJR, and another one is Musau MattmeachamJR Muhammad. So I appeal to my viewing audience, check out my books, and you'll find out that I write about a lot of things, and you may find some of the stuff I'm writing about quite interesting. So this is Musau MattmeachamJR, signing off on Earth.